Dude, it's almost the end of my second term as debate captain for our debate crew. And last Saturday's tournament of 1812 was just a little disappointing.
It was rough.
Yeah, but I think the biggest problem was that there wasn't an established pricing system for our evidence exchange, and it wasn't working out. I think we need to get that fixed.
Yeah.
So to fix this problem, I think we should resubscribe to the premium Dropbox we had in the inception of our team back in 1791 by, you know, Hamilton.
Sounds good, but will the school even allow us to do that? And can we get all the team members to use it?
Yeah, that's a good question, but I think that the exchange system is just too disorganized right now to ignore. Having this Dropbox should really help the system get organized and efficient. James, I have to show you a new policy, okay? Why is Dropbox blocked? Well, you see, the Midway High School debate team has decided to find the access into the school-wide Dropbox program because the Dropbox is impeding first on the Midway High School debate team's ability to empower itself, and second, we wanted to raise some revenue.
That's ridiculous. Why would I have to pay a fee for something that the school should already provide for us anyways?
Well, we already instituted the fining system, so you're going to have to follow it.
Okay, that's ridiculous. I'm just going to create a proxy server and just get my way around it.
I mean, if you want to argue about it, then we should probably have a formal debate about it.
Fine. Then a formal debate it shall be.
Okay then.
Okay, James. I challenge you to a debate. 3:40. Be there. He says club rights take precedent over school establishments. This will lead to a chaotic, disorganized, and dysfunctional school. He also says that the school board is extending its power in establishing this Dropbox. However, the elastic clause of the student code of conduct justifies the Dropbox. The school code of conduct is merely a document establishing the broader ideal of the school. As long as the Dropbox extends the ideal of the school, education, it is justified.
Fixing the access to the Dropbox is a way to preserve club power. Extend that the Amendment 10 gives the clubs the power to explicitly delegate it to the school. This justifies the finding of the Dropbox by the Midway Debate Club. They say that there will be a dysfunctional school, but this is just a hypothetical speculation. You should ignore this. Also, an extension of the school power, they say, is justified by an elastic clause. However, this means that they can pretty much do anything with that same rhetoric. You should not allow this. The judge should vote for the fining of the Dropbox to preserve club power.
The real problem is that organization patterns are disorganized, for not only the debate team, but for the teachers and classes. We need a school-wide source system for organization and efficiency. School establishments should not be sabotaged by the individual clubs, because the clubs work for the school. The elastic clause is not an example stretch of power. His interpretation of the school code of conduct is limited. The Dropbox is wholly justified.
Alright guys, good debate. I've made my decision. I ultimately decide with the negative because the school conduct code, specifically the elastic clause, allows for the establishment of any necessary organizations, such as Dropbox. The elastic clause gives unenumerated rights to the school to establish any necessary organizations not explicitly stated in the school code of conduct. And while clubs can fundraise however they choose, their fundraising cannot interfere with school-wide organizations. Because school-wide institutions are supreme, and therefore the fining of the student Dropbox is against the student code of conduct. So, the judge's ballot goes to McCulloch.